Halo 3 ODST is known for having a unique atmosphere and pacing unlike anything that we had ever seen from Halo at the time of its release. But what if you rented the game from Blockbuster on a Sunday, knowing good and well you wouldn't be able to play the game during the weekdays because your parents didn't let you play games on a school night until you brought your grades up? And we all know Blockbuster had those great old 5-day rental windows, which means Friday night comes around and you need to hurry up and get ODST done. How would you do it? Well, interestingly enough, speedrunners in the Halo community have managed to run Halo 3 ODST in under 1 hour and 20 minutes. And just like our other Halo speedrun videos, we wanted to take a look at these runs and see how on earth is this possible. Let's go ahead and jump into it. Now, of course, before we fully go into it, we have to give a huge shout out to Heroic Rob, who is the world record holder, for letting us use his footage and for helping us out with questions for this run, along with Nagato, who is the second place holder, who was also extremely helpful with helping us break down this video. Links to their channels are in the description. So starting things off, we're going to look at Prepare to Drop and the first section of Mombasa Streets, as the typical run through of ODST starts out like this. Now, jumping out of your pod, you have to make sure you're crouched down to take less damage, you know, the holy crouch maneuver that always prevents you from death, apparently, if you can crouch at the right time. From there, the typical strat on this level is to make a run to the right and grenade the first group of enemies and quickly kill the rest of them before the enemies start to spread out. If they spread out too far, you might have to go and track them down to trigger the next sequences to start, so it's a lot easier if you can just kill them right off the get-go. During this run, we see Heroic Rob almost get completely trolled with a brute that had a bubble shield. But after dealing with that, when he gets into the building, he just mostly runs past all the enemies, throwing some grenades here and there, and he beat this level in just under 3 minutes, which definitely puts this one in one of the easier categories of Halo 3 ODST. Next, we're switching to Buck in Tayari Plaza, and right away, being familiar with the geometry in games like Halo 3 ODST, which definitely have some tighter areas than other types of Halo games, can be integral for moving quickly along. Having your coordinated jumps perfectly to make sure you're landing over the platforms to save time is really important. Along the way, as there's going to be a ton of enemies just shooting about, knowing where the health packs are is also really important in each level, as you can really decide and plan how much damage you're able to take, which can maybe help you plan ahead as to how many enemies you actually have to take out and how far you can just go. Later in this level, Rob again has a very close encounter with a brute before he makes a run past the hunters, just trying to clear out to the end section of this level as fast as possible. To end this level, all you have to do is just stand close enough to the drop pod and trigger it, and this level clears. Then we're back out to Mombasa Streets, which actually does count when you're doing full speedruns, unlike when you're going for speedrun achievements in the Master Chief Collection. So this definitely adds an extra challenge onto the ODST run, whereas completing ODST Legendary in MCC under 3 hours for that achievement doesn't require all of Mombasa Streets to be included. So this is a little bit harder when you're doing the full actual run here. Here the main strategy is just to walk through the building, killing a few enemies here and there, but overall, a very important aspect of speedrunning this game is having familiarity with everything about the streets section. It's really impressive to watch these speedrunners know how to navigate Mombasa Streets without getting lost even a little bit. I feel like every time we try to play through the streets of New Mombasa, we get completely lost, and half of it is just trying to figure out where we're supposed to be going. So it's cool to see a different perspective here. Of course, another major aspect of the Mombasa Streets sections are that there are enemies that are scripted to stay in specific locations, so technically if you can run past them, a lot of the times they won't actually follow you, which does give you a bit of an advantage if you can get around them without either being spotted or without getting killed in the short time that you're in their vicinity. Uplift Reserve is the next level that is tackled, and since Luke and I here at Rocket Sloth are technically in the top 3 Halo 3 ODST players to clear Uplift Reserve co-op on easy difficulty on the MCC, as you can see from this footage, we were complete madmen completely crushing the competition with our Halo 3 ODST skills here. We know some of the challenges that this level can bring. But to kick things off, a popular technique is to throw a grenade at your feet to give yourself a little bit of extra boost to get over to the rocks that are just behind the bench, which save a couple of seconds. From there, you can immediately take out the chopper in the back with a Spartan laser and then hop in the Warthog to move up just far enough, avoiding all of those wraiths that can just end your day, and get in a ghost, which would be much faster and help with navigation in the second part of this level. From there, if you find the right section, you can actually just drive the ghost right up a rock wall and cut to the right, and you can actually skip a whole section that has a lot of enemies and a lot of just driving around, which is really useful here. From there, if you line yourself up and you hope for the best when it comes to RNG and how enemies move about, you can drive right past the wraiths and get to the bridge section, and allows you into the next area where once again you can drive up a rock wall and skip quite a bit before you head straight to the end and make the jump as fast as possible. This then puts us into Mombasa Streets Part 3, which is very similar to the previous times, where most of the time is just knowing where to go and running past everything and getting to the end just as quickly as possible. There is one part where we see Rob use an explosive battery to give himself a little bit of a boost. He also is aware of these jackals that have sniper rifles, and he takes them out right before they're able to see him. Later, he goes ahead and gets a mongoose from the garage and drives on to the end of this level. Next, we go on to Oni Alpha Site, and the main strategy here is to get up to the tower to trigger the bridge part as fast as possible. There is an NPC up in the tower that can get in the way of what you're trying to do, so it's best to push him to the side so he doesn't bother you. Going into the next open area, there are some hunters, and prioritizing them definitely helps out a lot. And if you just go forward quickly, clearing out waves of enemies, saving that Spartan laser from earlier is pretty useful here, as you can use that to take out the bigger enemies that will help the game load next sequences faster. Once again, knowing what sandbox of weapons are available can be incredibly useful here. We see Heroic Rob use a Spartan laser and rocket launcher to prepare for the area after he goes into the building, which are really helpful for spawn killing a bunch of enemies when they run through. The brutes can be a little bit scary as they spawn in groups of three, but with some careful precision, you can be safe and make sure you can survive through this section. On the elevator, if you plan ahead, you can actually spawn kill some of the buggers, which helps out making that section a lot easier to survive through. And when we get to the rooftop section, it seems like speedrunners tend to focus mostly on the brute chieftain that has the hammer first and then finish off the other brutes afterwards. Then there's a quick trick you can do to end this level early by throwing a grenade at the gunner, which causes the pelican gunner to step aside, and then jumping from the roof, you can get into the turret early and end the level. Onward to Mombasa Streets Part 4. Best method here is just to jump in a mongoose and drive past as many enemies as you can, and other than one small area where you could get sniped, there aren't too many risks here. Going on to Kazingo Boulevard, things start to get a little bit more complicated. To start things off, you have a rocket launcher, so you can just kind of go ham on some enemies there. We do see Heroic Rob do a ghost hijack as soon as the enemy ship drops the ghost off, and then drives past the wraith and multiple ghosts and enemies along the way. Now, typically this level, you're supposed to just be in a tank, so it's incredibly challenging in some parts to navigate when you're just in a ghost, and there's a lot of RNG that can go into it. When you get into the main plaza area, there is a banshee that you can hijack. However, this isn't a typical hijack. You actually have to do a frame-specific glitch if you want to get a hijack on this banshee. Now, this glitch is a little bit complicated. There actually is an achievement for doing it in the Master Chief Collection as some sort of Easter egg, but you're gonna have to shoot the banshee down with a plasma pistol and then kill the brute at the same time while holding the boarding button. Very similar to the AA Wraith glitch in Halo 3, except it's a little more complicated because it's a banshee, and just the way that you have to time out killing the brute driver, it can be a little complicated. Of course, tie that together that the banshee can just be really random with how it likes to fly around, and drawing the banshee into the right area where you can hijack it is hard enough. So to have the stars align properly to save time can be very frustrating and challenging. However, if you do get the banshee, you can actually skip a section of the level by doing some elastic barrier breaking and checkpoint triggering, which actually teleports Dutch to the end area. And from there, you basically can just go ahead and clear the rest of the enemies and end this level. Moving on to Mombasa Streets Part 5, which is just another ride in the park, as long as you know where you're going. Next, we're jumping into the level with a bunch of letters, NMPDHQ. Real quick, I just wonder if anyone at Bungie ever actually said that list of letters out loud and thought to themselves, this is a great level name. In the beginning area, it's important to know where the enemies are, as they'll pop up quickly and you're gonna have to snipe them down. We do see Heroic Rob do some grenade jumps and skip a few stairs to save a few extra seconds here and there when pushing forward. And you can get killed with RNG here easily, especially since you lose your shield from doing one of those grenade skips. But overall, doing those skips can actually save enough time where it's more beneficial than risky. The main focus is just to take out the Jackal snipers, as they're the biggest threat. And when getting to the final Banshee fight, you have to shoot down the Phantoms so the fight will go along faster. This is kind of a weird section of the level, but focusing more on the Phantoms first is probably the better priority. Of course, if you can't hit a Phantom, hitting the Banshees still help lead things along. Now, it can get kind of hectic hectic here, as the NPCs sometimes take a bit to react and help you along the way, and the phantoms actually spawn in a random order every time, so you can't predict ahead of time where things are going to be. So you almost have to have extremely quick reactions to know what to aim at and when. Of course, the Spartan laser doesn't work here on the phantoms, but if you use a missile pod, it takes just 6 shots to take out a phantom. Also, before you take out the last phantom, you want to make sure that Buck does yell the line jetpacks, otherwise the game will soft lock for some reason. Boom! Mombasa Streets Part 6, and it's just another drive.
Yeah.
But then we get to Kikuwani Station, one of my favorite levels from Halo, you know, the one that I've spent 10 plus hours on, probably longer the more I think about it. But dropping in, we see a quick grenade boost to the stairs to take out all of the enemies and use a brute shot to move things along, fast jumping into a Banshee. Then you have the sequence where you have to wait for the squad to hijack the Phantom. So in the meantime, the best strategy is just to take out all of the enemies in the starting area and grab a fuel rod gun while you're at it. If you fly back over to the squad and you shoot Romeo quick enough as he gets up, it'll actually make the run move along a little bit quicker, which is kind of nice. From there, we can see speedrunners skip pretty much the first section almost completely by flying up into the room and heading right to the next big door. In the indoor section, the best strategy here is to take out all the other batteries and fly through the next outdoor section and go straight inside and leave the Banshee behind. Inside, he takes out all the enemies with the sniper rifle and the fuel rod gun and unlocks the next door, and then he gets into another Banshee and pretty much just flies straight past the Scarab, avoiding it, opens the door, and snipes the batteries at the end, which trigger the end sequence of this level. For New Mombasa Streets Part 7, this one's just pretty much a really short drive, so it's basically not even a level. But then we're on good old Data Hive, and this is one of the longer levels, of course, in Halo 3 ODST. Now, this level is kind of split into 3 sub-levels that you have to go through to complete this level. Starting on the first sub-level, which is technically sub-level 7 in the game, it's basically just a run through the tunnels situation while trying not to alert any enemies along the way to make things a little easier on you. At some point, you have to shoot some grunts because they are in the way, but if done right, you can actually make it to the drop down in the next sub-level pretty fast without any real attention being drawn to you. Now, right before dropping down, we see Heroic Rob throw a grenade first at his feet, which bounces off the floor and kills the buggers that are technically going to come up to kill you, which is pretty useful. And going into the second sub-level, the main strategies that are used here might not revolve around being sneaky as much as in the first area. The main strategy is just to never stop walking and continue to push forward and take out as many enemies and brutes along the way. We see in this run, there's actually some sections where there's some pretty close calls with the amount of enemies in the short hallways that can easily mess your run up. However, after pushing a little bit further, you can drop down to the final section, and honestly, as you continue to push towards the end area of this level, using the noob combo is very, very useful here, as there isn't as much cover going forward and you're gonna have to deal with a lot of enemies. Then we get to the actual hive part of the level, and there's a skip you can do that lets you go straight to the upper level with the bridges. Now, of course, there's multiple ways to do this, but in this speedrun, we see Heroic Rob do a method that is the fastest, but also one of the more inconsistent ones that is a little bit more risky. There's 2 plasma batteries right under the upper part that you're trying to get onto. By pushing them together and jumping on top of them and shooting them, the upward momentum can actually launch you up high enough where you can make it to the upper platforms. From there, he actually drops down to the middle section to cut diagonally between them and save some more time, and then uses a brute shot to get back up to the upper area once again. When you get to the area at the end of this level where the Chieftain is, you want to make sure you take out the brute that is standing next to him immediately, and then proceed to headshot the Chieftain and the second brute. From there, you need to boost down the hallway with the gravity hammer from the Chieftain and activate the final little section of this level. After a short cutscene, the main thing you have to do is escape, and you're going to have to deal with some jetpack brutes, which you can actually assassinate along the way, and using the gravity hammer that you had from earlier and a brute shot, you can take out some enemies that drop in from the Phantom quickly and continue down into the building. Now, of course, it can get frustrating because you also have to wait on the NPC squad mates to move along if you ever want to beat this level. We see Heroic Rob push Dare really quickly with a hammer, and then he has to wait for Virgil to open the door, which is just always fun to have to sit around and wait. And then after that, we're going on to Coastal Highway next. Now, the beginning of this level is pretty straightforward and easy. Just run through, and while doing so, kill as many enemies as possible. We do see some strategies where you need to give Virgil a little push with the gravity hammer, you know, just to speed him up and activate that first cutscene a little bit quicker. When we we get to the final escort driving section, we see the speedrunners jump into a warthog and has Buck shoot at all of the enemies. Typically, a good strategy is just to drive ahead of the elephant, or olephant if you prefer pronouncing it that way, and take out the enemies way ahead before the elephant moves up forward. One of the biggest threat parts is mostly this area with all of the ghosts, as there's a lot of ghosts, and they can deal a ton of damage depending on what difficulty you're on. You can use a rocket launcher or fuel rod gun to take them out quicker, since otherwise you can get completely wrecked by these things. And as you continue to push on, there are some banshees that can do a lot of damage as well. Jump in that Gozhog, boys, and just take out the rest of the enemies with Buck's help, hopefully. Now, one thing we really liked about this run is that Heroic Rob actually does this amazing rocket launcher takedown on the first banshee, and he takes out the Wraith with it too, and continues back to Buck in the Gozhog. But then you're gonna have to just say goodbye to Buck, leave him behind, because he takes way too long to get in the tank when you get to the part with the scorpion, and just drive up and take out the Wraith and some banshees. And honestly, watching this run on Heroic Rob's video is so intense and nail-biting, because there's so many really, really close calls where you think he's not gonna make it. It gets to the point where the tank is just on fire, and Heroic Rob jumps in a warthog without a gun or anything, just because he feels like it's safer to drive to the end of this area than staying in the tank any longer. From there, there's the final firefight section, which just comes down to how quickly you kill the main enemies that trigger the next wave to come in. But obviously, if you're really familiar with speedrunning this game, you gotta know where all of the spawn points are for the sets of enemies as they drop, and using the weapons and different types of equipment nearby, you can take out the big enemies as fast as possible and kind of predict not only where they're gonna spawn, but also the pathways that they're gonna use to move up in trying to kill Virgil. And from that is how essentially speedrunners have managed to beat this game under an hour and 20 minutes. Heroic Rob with the impressive 116.23, and of course Nagato with the second place 119.35. Honestly, these are incredible runs, and it's so cool to see a game that's really intended for a slower, more methodical approach being kind of twisted in a different way, in a different playstyle. So there you guys go. Jump on Halo 3 ODST, get your game finished, and get that return to Blockbuster so you can rent another game and your mom won't get mad at you for having a late fee on your game. See, and you guys think we're not ever looking out for y'all. But hey, if you guys enjoyed this video, please do a favor. Double check down below that you are subscribed with notifications on. If this is your first time ever watching a video, or maybe you've seen us pop up a couple of times and recommended, it does mean the world to us if you're subscribed, because we're really trying to put content out that's entertaining, especially when it's in regards to things like speedrunning or Halo or just other types of topics. So make sure you guys are subscribed. We'd really appreciate it. But hey, after all of that, if you like this video, be sure to subscribe with notifications on for more videos just like this one, and you won't miss anything we upload, even if YouTube's acting all whack. Also, if you want to, you can follow us on Twitter. You can follow me at Rocket Elijah, or you can follow Luke at Rocket Sloth Luke. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you all next time with a brand new video. Bye, guys.